Played every sport, baseball, basketball, soccer. And once, you know, people started getting bigger, really couldn't carry on with the football and basketball. So I got into wrestling, which is a perfect sport for a smaller guy like me. So that's how I did it. Wrestled through middle school, high school, and a little bit of college.
When did the idea of fighting come across your mind?
You know, initially I just did it because I wanted to get back in shape. And just, you know, learn some skills. And then once I started doing it, I was like, you know what, I'll have one fight. I just wanted to do one fight just to say I did it. And then I had one fight and just carried on. Surprisingly, I've never been in a street fight. Still to this day, I've never been in a street fight. I'm a really nice, outside of the gym or outside of the cage, really mellow. You would never know that I would go in and fight MMA. But the first time, it's crazy. Crazy nervous. I was like, why am I even doing this? Like, what possessed me to do something like this? And, you know, I still get a little bit of that feeling every time I, you know, getting ready to go in and fight, but I think it's good. It keeps you on your toes. You know, I don't look at it as going in to hurt someone. You know, I know that happens a lot, but I view it as like competing. Like, it's, you know, it's one of the few sports, you know, after you get out of school, college, whatever, if you're not going to the Olympics, that you can still compete in, you know, at a pretty high level. You have to be at pretty top physical shape to go in there and compete. And I just look at it as that, like pushing yourself, you know, to see what you can or can't do. And I don't look at it going in to hurt someone. Usually, out of all my fights, I've never gone in hating anyone. I've always come out of the cage friends with the person. People just don't understand the sacrifices that you have to do. Because, you know, a lot of people are just saying, hey, let's go out, let's have some beers, let's go have some food. You can't do that, you know. When you're getting ready for a fight, most of the time, everyone that I know is cutting weight to get ready for a fight. So when you're cutting weight, you can't go out and eat what you want to eat. You can't go out and drink. So you have to really be strict. You have to be discipline yourself, and that's what's huge. And I like that about MMA. You have to be disciplined, you know, not just in your eating habits, but, you know, coming in, putting in the work, getting into shape, you know. So you don't want to go in there unprepared. You know, I know I don't have any illusions of grandeur. I know I'm never going to be, you know, a John Jones or an Anderson Silva. I just like to, you know, like I was saying, compete, push myself, you know. I'll push myself and fight as long as I can to see how far I can go, you know. But, you know, you always got to have something to fall back on. And so I'll do it while I'm young and my body can still hold up to it. Being born and raised out of Texas, you know, I have those Southern values, you know. You know, your word is your bond. What you say, you know, you're going to do. If you say you're going to, just like in the fighting, you say you're going to fight, you know, I know it happens a lot, but people back out. And, you know, if you say you're going to do it, follow through with it. You know, trust, you know, being someone that, you know, anyone that you're friends with, you know, or colleagues with can come to you and ask you for help or advice or anything, you know. You know, I still think there's a little bit of a stigma attached to it. You know, like, oh, you're a fight, you know, maybe you're a meathead, or, you know, you're just at the drop of a dime, you're ready to fight someone. But I mean, that's the total opposite. So, you know, like I was saying earlier, I'm super mellow, easy to get along with, you know, friends with everyone, and that's just my personality.